previously.
A brilliant mind like mine needs to be preserved, so I need Olga to continue my work once she's ready.
Does she know she's not really your daughter, but an opposite sex clone of yours?
Watch out, they're all infected.
Bloody hell.
Is this the apocalypse?
It might degenerate into one if the mother isn't stopped. This herbicide I made from Dr. Strankov's chemicals and my own magic should be powerful enough to defeat her.
Our vaccine is currently experimental at best. This disease isn't deadly, not to adults anyway.
You used my sister as a guinea pig for your sick experiments.
Don't come any closer. I don't know what you are, but I don't want anything to do with it.
Regardless of what I am, I just saved your ass, and your sisters, and this town from a mad scientist that was going to get everybody brainwashed or killed. So I think we've arrived at a point where you could give me the benefit of the doubt, at least until this is over.
If you saved everybody, then why is your sister still in a coma?
Because yours is so opposed to giving her the vaccine that cured Loki.
His recovery likely had more to do with the fever's short-term effects simply wearing off than Mrs. Ravenhurst's prophylactic vaccine. I doubt they've gotten far enough in their research to come up with a therapeutic one. That shit takes time.
Come again.
Getting a prophylactic vaccine means you're injected with a harmless pathogen, or components thereof, to trigger the body's defense mechanism without posing an actual threat, so when the real disease hits, your body will know what to do. Think of it as a fire drill of sorts. But since Wilbica already got the real deal, that won't help her at this point. What she needs is either a therapeutic vaccine or an antidote, and I might be able to brew something up with the chemicals here, but no promises.
How can I help?
Stay away from me and Beryl.
Fine, I'm not exactly longing for your company either. Bitch, what are you doing here?
I was about to ask you the same thing, because I doubt the Princess Petty Pussy and her sister are responsible for that messy lasagna carpet in the living room, but then I remembered I can't even ask you anything because I don't have a voice. Shit happens.
Your blue-haired friend left shortly after regaining his strength, and the others went to the lab, to save your mother among other things, so bitch insisted on coming here to see how you are doing.
Where did Loki go?
He didn't say. I left the room for a few seconds, and when I came back, he was gone.
It appears to me that he was trying to avoid being seen by your father, who was sneaking around the house for a while. I didn't realize they knew each other.
I don't like that guy, and I trust him even less. Anyway, I'm going to the lab too. There's nothing for me to do here at the moment, but maybe I can help my mother.
Cool. Off we go.
No, bitch. You stay here and keep Willy safe. And don't take any chances. I don't want you to get hurt too.
My masters and their annoying overprotectiveness. I'm their pet familiar. It's my job to look out for them, not the other way around.
Be glad you don't belong to Noel Frost. He is too familiar to what Dr. Strankov was to the population of StrangerVille.
What is this weather? I've never seen a thunderstorm this colorful.
Me neither. It's like gay angels are having a party somewhere over the rainbow. You picked the worst imaginable time to come here, Valerie.
We can't be picky when civilian lives are at stake. That thunderstorm isn't natural, it must be the mother's doing, and if it spreads past the crater.
So now you want us to take on the mother with some herbicide that a stranger dropped off at our doorstep? How do you know it's not going to make her even stronger instead?
Because I examined it. Well, the other me, the one that actually understands chemistry. It contains some kind of... whatever, who cares? Just believe me that it will work. Now let's go downstairs so I can destroy this abomination before I do the same to its sick, twisted creator that calls itself my father.
Did something happen to Captain Strankova, or is she always this angry?
Well, she learned today that she was genetically engineered to be the perfect soldier. No wonder Red Olga took over. It's probably some kind of coping mechanism.
That doesn't sound so stupid. Why does the government never come up with ideas like that?
Martin.
What? I'm just saying what everybody is thinking.
Explain to me again what exactly the mother is.
You'll see for yourself soon enough.
You. Why are you alone? Didn't you have a partner at some point? Go look for him, and then I want you to go out there and oversee the area. Make sure the truck incident from earlier doesn't repeat itself.
I'd rather not.
Why? If you're worried about the party of the gay angels, I'm sure Captain Strankova will lend you her cap. It contains rubber that will protect you from the lightning.
Okay.
That's some of the biggest bullshit I've heard all day.
You and I know that, but that boulder punching jarhead whose biceps are bigger than his brain doesn't.
Do you enjoy putting your soldiers into dangerous situations that could get them killed?
Only the dumb ones that no one would miss. You're coming with me. The rest of you, guard all doors. Don't let anybody in who isn't wearing a uniform.
Yes, go. Aya has been gone for too long. She might need help destroying the mother.
You there. You don't look like a soldier. Are you one of Strankov's scientists?
Shit.
Hello. I'm talking to you. That guy looked familiar.
Hey! This is a quarantine zone. Identify yourself.
You don't know who I am. Too bad. There goes your chance at an autograph. Now be an obedient soldier and take off your uniform.
Damn it. The pollen is blocking the way. We can't go through here without risking infection.
Those scientists are working with biohazardous materials on a daily basis. They're bound to have hazmat suits somewhere.
They do. In a chamber past this corridor. Shit.
No reason to resort to foul language, you overdramatic dumbasses. There's another way around.
Okay, no breathing from here on out.
Officer, what's going on? Is it finally over?
Ted?
You? Who called you back to StrangerVille? Damn, hell just got hotter.
Thank you. What happened to you? The last time we met, you were just a jealous unkempt cowboy, not a jealous unkempt vampire.
Hell if I know. Came here because of an upset stomach, but instead of giving me medicine as usual, the doctor's assistants made me eat some fruit I'd never seen before, and the next thing I remember is waking up like this, always thirsty, with no mirror reflection, and unable to go out because of the sun. But at least the stomach pain is gone.
Congratulations, they must have used you as a test subject to study the effects of the forbidden fruit. Any idea where they're keeping it?
The fruit? I haven't seen it since. But during the days that followed, everybody around me began to turn into those green plant thingies and the soldiers locked us up down here, until an old woman came in, fired a few bullets and turned me into black smoke.
Sounds like something my mother would do.
That was the weirdest experience in my entire life, and I say that as a straight man who once got fucked in the ass by his wife with a strap on.
At least it didn't last very long. Not long enough for the spell to reverse itself, and my mother wasn't around to reverse it either, but you still turned back early, so... something must have happened to her.
Forget it. You're not going in there without a keycard, and we should all pray that what's inside will never get out either. It would be too much for my town to handle.
But my mother is in there.
Then she's probably dead by now, eaten alive by the other mother. Sorry, pal.
Are you coming, Grande?
These plants. What are they? Where did they come from?
The Prodigium plant has been around for as long as even the oldest residents of StrangerVille can remember, the superstitious among them always blaming it for every good or bad thing that happened to the town. The most popular theory is that it's alien in nature, supported by two facts. First, it originated from the crater, and a crater is usually the result of a meteorite impact. Second, prodigium consumption makes people susceptible to mind control, a trait also found in an alien crystal called nightlight.
It's pronounced nitolite.
Tiamo, I thought you were with Wilbica.
How did you get past the pollen in the upper corridor without a hazmat suit? Screw that, how did you get past my soldiers? Damn, I could really use better personnel.
Once you're done ranting, perhaps you could lend me your key for this door.
Throw it away. That thing is a plant, right? If you just stop watering it, maybe it'll wither and die.
So the day has finally come. We're fighting the mother. Follow me.
No. The mother is my father's most impressive project so far. We can't destroy her. I am his most impressive project. Death to the mother. We shouldn't be calling any of my father's projects impressive.
I'm afraid Olga EXE has stopped working.
A clear sign not to go on.
No one asked you to come along.
Could this be caused by her proximity to the mother? What if Strankoff genetically engineered her to be unable to fight his other big project?
Uh-oh.
Must continue my father's work.
Let her go. We'll deal with it later. The mother comes first.
Well then, time to go. Bye.
On my command. Spread out.
What? Are you going to growl at me every time you see me now?
You growl at my family every time you see them, yet only one of us is a dog, so who are you to judge?
I can't help your mistress if you don't let me.
With that stuff you just brewed up? It could be poison.
Don't be silly, bitch. It's not like Wilbica's condition could get any worse than it already is at this point. This fever kills children.
I'm not so sure I like you being able to hear my thoughts, Judith. Why you of all people? Because we're both not human?
I need to give her a shot, and the sooner I do that, the more likely it is to work. We don't have any time to waste.
Fine, but you saw what Tiamo did to Strankoff. That's what I'll do to you if you screw this up.
You worry too much. The biggest threat to this town has already been defeated.
That's what you say. I think the biggest threat is being fought as we speak, and there's nothing I can do to help.
Don't let up. We can do this.
I don't know who gave you this shit, but it seems to be working. She's getting weaker.
How can you tell? Still looks big and scary to me.
Martin. Let him go, you overgrown mother of bitches.
Is that all you've got? Too bad for you.
Now is not a good time to brag.
Take this.
We made it. I can't believe we actually defeated it.
Are you all right?
I'm fine.
What are you doing?
What do you think I'm doing? Ted said that thing ate my mother. She must be in here somewhere.
No. You Muppets, what have you done?
Mum, you're safe. So you were never attacked by the mother?
Of course not. Why would this lovely plant attack me? I'm not the one who approached her looking like a yellow night wraith with a chemical weapon.
Then what have you been doing all this time?
We were just chatting, discussing our plans for the future and world domination. You know, the usual small talk. Then I left to quickly check on my beautiful thunderstorm. I was gone for 5 minutes tops. How could you ruin everything in such a short time?
Wait, you conjured up that thunderstorm? We assumed it was caused by gay angels. Gay angels. Or something like that.
Conspiring with the mother, huh? Unbelievable. I never trusted you, should have arrested you the first time we met.
And I should have done this.
Stop it.
Finally. Can you hear that? The sound of silence, without some obnoxious know-it-alls babbling non-stop? I love it.
You still have a lot of explaining to do.
Nah, I'll save that for your sister and bitch. I bet they'll be a lot more receptive to the plans I had with the mother. Plans that I can now forget about thanks to the StrangerVille military. Let's go look for them.
Young mistress?
Grandfather?
Excuse me, I'm 3 years old, female, and alive. Granted, it's hard to tell for humans because I'm a dog, but I'm sure your dead grandfather wasn't.
Bitch, it's so good to see you. But Dr. Strankov, is he? That was Beryl.
You murdered my father.
No, we didn't, but that asshole had it coming nevertheless.
Beryl.
What?
My father is dead. Someone has to be punished.
He was a terrible person. Not just to the people of StrangerVille who adored him, but even to his own daughter, or should I say, his favorite test subject.
What's that supposed to mean?
It's true, all there in the doctor's experiment logbook. Meet Project O2, his opposite sex clone, whom he deliberately endowed with a split personality so she could quickly adapt to any kind of situation, making her highly intelligent and sociable, but also capable of defending herself. She's basically her creator, but better, and was designed for the sole purpose of continuing his work when he's gone.
Our work is important. The global population is at an all-time high, but most newborns grow up to be imbeciles, supernatural monsters, or both, teaming up to rob our planet of its resources that could be spent on science and progress. If we don't act now, everything that is good will soon drown in a swamp of nonsense produced by unnecessary people, and if I have to dedicate my life to preventing that, then that's what I'm going to do.
Clone or not, the apple clearly didn't fall far from the tree here.
This isn't the real Olga anymore.
Says who? You barely know her.
True, but I do know very well what abuse can do to people, and you, Olga, have been abused all your life, programmed to match somebody else's ideal image of you. You're not your father, not even close, at least judging by the side of you that I got to know in Windenburg. Clone or not, you're still your own person.
You should listen to the little girl. You don't know me, or my father.
Maybe not. In fact, I didn't even know my own father, because he left the family when I was too young to even remember him. My mother remarried, then she died, leaving me in the care of a man so perfect that he could never admit a mistake, and so he turned a blind eye when his son, my stepbrother, started molesting me.
So every man in your life has either mistreated or left you behind. What else have they accomplished? Probably not much. You should hate them enough to long for a world without people like them.
You bet, but I hated myself even more, believing that I somehow deserved it, because nothing happens without a reason, right? Bullshit. People abuse you because they can, and you owe it to yourself to fight back against them rather than punishing yourself for their actions. Your father wasn't a hero, he was your worst enemy, and you can't let him win.
But this is my purpose in life. I have to think of the future of mankind.
A wise man once told me, whatever the future may hold, it isn't here yet. Focus on the present, otherwise you're only setting yourself up for regret. Perhaps we should all take this to heart.
Who's that wise man? I'm totally stealing his quote.
Your current state, this desire of yours to follow in Strankov's footsteps. It isn't natural. It's a poison he's injected you with, literally. But Serena has developed an antidote that seems to work just fine. She can help you if you let her.
The death of a loved one is never expected and always tragic, but we will never forget what Dr. Oleg Strankov has done for this town.
Yeah, like spreading an epidemic among its citizens, and most of them don't even know who they have to thank for that. Remind me why I'm attending his memorial ceremony again, if not to spit on his corpse.
To support Olga, of course. And because it's the coolest building in this town. The dry heat outside is killing me.
Me too, the sun especially. Say, is it just me, or does my wife look tastier than usual?
It's you, vampire.
Good to see everything is normal again. At least if you consider it normal to hold a memorial ceremony at the local library, that is.
What did you expect? With only 5 or so public buildings in the entire town, one of which is currently inaccessible thanks to the tendrils of a gigantic plant, you can't be too picky.
True. What about you, though? Are you normal again, too?
What do you mean?
You seem less depressed than before. Did anything happen?
Did anything not happen lately? I'm just glad that Mum got her forbidden fruit back. The mother plant of all things told her where Strankov was keeping it. Now we can officially kiss this fucking town goodbye for good.
Grande.
Director Ravenhurst. And General Ravenhurst. I take it you're here to apprehend me.
What for? I don't particularly like you or your friends, but my wife insists that that's no excuse to arrest somebody.
What my husband is trying to say, in his own very socially awkward way, is that we'd like to thank you for your assistance in bringing down the mother and saving this town. And our son. If you ever feel like returning to the SCIA.
Thanks, but I'm happy where I am now.
Your new boss must be doing something right then. Where is she now?
Probably making arrangements for our trip back home. I'll give her your regards.
See you around, Grande.
Hopefully not.
I'm not socially awkward.
See you around, but hopefully not. That's what the doctor used to say to his patients because he wanted them to be healthy and not come visit him again too soon. But I've wasted enough of your time by telling you things you already know. I'm sure his daughter would like to say a few words too. Olga.
Are you okay, Olga?
No. I can't take it anymore. This hypocrisy, this hero worship for a man who deserves none of it. It's too much.
Is there anything we can do?
Yes. Promise me something. Tiamo, you killed Strankov.
I'm sorry.
Don't be, because you might have to do it again, when I turn into him.
What are you saying?
Something we all know. I was never my father's daughter. I'm his clone, which means that whatever crazy gene made him do the things he did, I have it too. 10 or 20 years from now, I could be the one cloning myself and experimenting on the rest of the town for my own megalomaniac purposes. And if it comes to that, I'll need your help.
That's never going to happen.
Really? You know what else I thought was never going to happen? Me sleeping with a man. But I did, I remember now, I slept with you, and you know why? Because Strankov couldn't bear the thought of his precious Project O2 never producing biological offspring, so he reconfigured my thrill-seeking personality to make her indifferent to the sex of her partners as long as they give her the thrill she needs. It's all there in his logbook, as Judith said, and if he had that kind of power over me, who knows what other safety measures he took to make sure I'll never stray from the path he set me on.
Paths can be altered.
Not this one, and you know it. I've been a prodigium zombie for all my life without realizing it. I was born this way and I'll die this way, that's for sure. But what happens until then is still up in the air, and if I can't stop myself from becoming a monster, I need you to do it. Promise me,